Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. Hear ye the word of the Lord. Comfort your hearts with these words. Again I say, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he were dead, shall live. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and in the last he will stand upon the earth, and after my skin has been thus destroyed, then without my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see on my side, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. The Lord give, and the Lord take it away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In the morning, sow your seed, and at evening, withhold not your hand, for you do not know which will prosper, these or that, or whether both alike will be good. Light is sweet, and it is pleasant for the eye to behold the sun. For if a man lives many years, let him rejoice in them all. But let him remember that the days of darkness will be many. All that comes is vanity.
Makes no difference what the problem. Broken heart. comfort, strengthen and keep you, Lord. Oh, I can call him when I need him. Our Father up in heaven, I can go God in prayer. Oh, I can go. Makes no difference what the problem. Oh, yes, I have this blessed assurance. Oh, he will take my gloom and sorrow. Comfort and keep you. Oh, I can call when I need him. Oh, Father, oh, when I can go. Out, yeah, yeah.
Yes, he can.
Yes. Oh, he'll brighten up your day. He can win you back.
Yes,
oh, yeah. Oh, when you are down and out, my God will bring you out. Oh,
yes,
yeah.
Oh, yes, he can.
Oh, I can call, when I need him.
Oh,
I can go call in prayer. Oh, I can go. He can work it out. My God can work it out.
Our
Father,
I can call him
when I need him. Our Father,
oh,
in heaven, I can call him
when
our Father.
Come on, let's give God praise that we know we can go to God in prayer. Come on, you can do better than that. This family needs your strength today. If you know that we can go to God in prayer, would you put your hands together? Oh, come on, let's give God praise for the life. Geoffrey Johnson III, come on, let's give God praise for Fat today. Come on, we need your strength. The family needs it. Come on. If you know you can go to God in prayer, put your hands together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey. We give honor and respect to this family. Want to let you know that we are here praying for you. Thank God for the shepherd of this house, Dr. Ramsey. and the clergy that assist on the pulpit. We're going to go into our program today. We'll have the prayer by Reverend Rufus Copeland, followed by the scripture readings, Old Testament Evangelist Anthony Pringle, New Testament Bishop Douglas Watkins, and a musical selection by his uncle, Daryl Joyner, in that order. Pastor Copeland.
It has been said, I know I can go to God in prayer. It is my desire to ask you to humble your heart, bow your head. Let us go to God in prayer. Omnipotent, omniscient, and omnipresent God, you're everywhere at the same time. And we can worship you everywhere, all the time. Even in the midst of grief and sorrow, our God is still good. And Father God, we want to lift up our family. Father God, we want to pray your blessing upon the Johnson as well as the Jones. We pray, Father God, right now that you would comfort, strengthen, and keep. Lord, we've already seen your healing hand. Continue to heal our broken hearts. And Lord, give us wisdom that we can commit our loved one into your care. You give life, but Father God, at the appropriate time, we'll call home for repair. Father God, we acknowledge that it seemed too short, but we know that you are sovereign and all things are in your hand. And for that, Father God, we just want to thank you for the life that was so well lived of Geoffrey. Lord, to so many of us, it seems that in 15 years, he lived more than some people live in 70 or 80. Lord, we just thank you, Lord, that he was close to you, that somebody brought him up in the nurture and the fear and the admonition of the Lord, and he was leaning on the Lord's side. And Father God, for that, we have a confident knowing that one of these old days in glory land, we're all going to be together again. Oh, Father God, we just right now ask that you continue to keep us all humble and keep us all leaning on your everlasting arm that we can trust in, wait on, lean on, and depend on you. And we'll even understand it better by and by. But Father God, we ask these and all blessings to the glory of God. We ask it for the good of this, our family. Keep us now in your care. We ask it in Jesus' precious name, the name that is above every name, every heartache, every pain, the name of Jesus above all. We ask it in Jesus' name. And the church said, amen.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Somebody ought to clap those hands and tell God, thank you. Shout glory. Oh, here come the Lord of the host. Shout. Hallelujah. Hey. Shout, yeah. Oh, here come the Lord of the host. Shout. Hey! Somebody ought to shout, thank you! Thank you! Oh! Hey! Woo! Oh! Woo! Hallelujah! Hey! You come down out of a whole shot. Woo! Hey! He's a good God. Even in this, we don't charge God foolishly, but we shout glory. Hey! Ah, yeah.
I'm going to read the Old Testament scripture.
The family know what they was doing when they asked me to do this. Hayamashanda. We ought to be strength for the family. Hayamashah. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Hey, hey, hey. Oh. Psalms 30, verse 1 through 5. I will extol thee, O Lord, for thou hast lifted me up and hast not made my foes to rejoice over me. O Lord, my God, I cry unto thee, and thou hast healed me. O Lord, thou hast brought up my soul from the grave. Thou hast kept me alive, that I should not go down to the pit. Sing unto the Lord, O ye saints of his, and give thanks at the remembrance of his holiness. For his anger endureth but a moment, and in his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night. Weeping may endure for a night. But joy cometh in the morning. Clap your hands and give God praise.
Well, somebody ought to praise him. Ah, somebody tell you. This is what we do over here, y'all. Oh, somebody praise him. Just need somebody to remember those Sunday mornings when we was at church and Fat was on the floor giving God praise. Oh, somebody, come on, get it. Let's give her praise for Fat this morning, y'all. Take it in, y'all. Well, that's it, Overseer Johnson. That's it, Overseer Fluid. Take it in, y'all. Somebody just lean back and scream and holler victory. I believe we got the victory this morning, y'all. I believe we got the victory, y'all. Oh, glory. Somebody lift those hands and give God a praise. Hallelujah. We got the victory. We got the victory, brother. Glory to God. We got the victory. Amen. Real quick, y'all. I got to read my scripture now. Marcus, I got to read my scripture. But we got the victory, y'all. Oh, y'all better praise him. Y'all better praise him. He's here, y'all. He's here, y'all. Overseer Flood, he's here. He's here. Amen. We're getting ready to read our scripture. Amen. But the preacher told us last night, the Lord told him what? It is well. And I believe it. He let us know right now, it's well. The anointing is here, y'all. The power of God is here. It's here, baby. He's here. He's here. Oh, glory. Amen. Our scripture, amen, is Matthew, the 28th chapter and the 20th verse. Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I command you. And lo, I am with you always. I think I'll say that again. And lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. Amen. May God add a blessing to the reading of his word.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Very hard time for the whole family. Amen. But at a time like this, we must encourage ourselves. Amen. Oh, sometimes you have to encourage yourself. Oh, sometimes you have to speak victory during the test. And no matter how you feel, just speak a word and you will be heard. Speak over yourself. Encourage yourself in the Lord. Oh, 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 sometimes you have to speak the word over yourself. Well, the enemies created walls, but remember giants, they do fall. Encourage yourself, speak over yourself in the Lord. Oh, as I minister to you, oh, I minister to my soul. Life can have you so until you feel there's nothing left. Well, the enemy created walls, but oh, your hands fall. Speak over yourself. Encourage yourself in the Lord. Oh, 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 oh. Hallelujah. Now that there was for the new school folk. If I could take it back old school for a couple of seconds. Y'all come on and go with me real quick. If you call on Jesus, he'll answer prayer. Call on Jesus. Ah, call on Jesus. If you call on Jesus. If you call on Jesus. If you call on Jesus. At a time like this, he'll answer. At a time like this. If you call Jesus. If you call Jesus, oh, call him. Oh.
Oh dear, oh dear. He's an answering God. He's a prayer walker. He's a miracle worker. He'll answer you. If you call him, you've been calling him. He's going to answer. Wow! Wow! Shandavos, he'll answer. He'll give you strength in the midst of a storm. Yeah! Yeah! Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. Answer prayer. Said if you call on Jesus, if you call on Jesus, oh,
question about it. He will get what you need. He will answer prayer. Let's thank God for a prayer answering God. Tell your neighbor he will answer prayer. Moving along. I won't get no trouble, so we move along. But he will answer prayer. What a gifted family this is. We're moving on. Didn't know fat believe in praising the Lord. Praise God. We gonna move on. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all gonna get me in trouble. All right. 10, 9, 8, 7, get it out, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Tell your neighbor, we'll get another one. We'll get another one. Thank God for those that have come. We want to, glory to God, want to move on, but let me help you understand something. This is a praising family. Fat was a praiser. Praise God. But we're going to, we don't want to bear too much burden on the family because this does get to be exhausting for them. Amen. But we're going to shout again. I know it. I know it will. Praise the Lord. So just hold your mule for just a second so we can move on, and we're going to come back up here and praise God. Praise the Lord. But I got another yes, Lord, in my soul. We're going to have a poem in memory of Fat by his aunt, Shakia Flood. Following Shakia, we will have reflections. Please, I have the difficult job in having to be the one that tells you it's time to wrap it up. So we're asking that you could at least stay at 2 minutes or less for reflections. So following Shakia will be Fat's principal, Miss Valeria Smith, and then a teacher, Miss Walker, and then another teacher, Miss Mason Darby. We ask that you would come in that order. Amen.
Everybody, could y'all hear me? Yes. I'm gonna try my best to say what I gotta say, but it won't be long. Anybody who knew Fat or Geoffrey, whatever y'all call him, Lil Fizz, they, y'all know he was a praiser, right? So I didn't write a poem, but when I asked God to give me peace, he did. Because I was, y'all excuse me, I told him to give me peace and he did. And when he gave me peace, he let me know that he was in heaven with my father. And anybody who knew my father knew he was a bishop. And that he loved him some Shirley. So, if y'all don't mind, but I know you was like for a quick second because my poem, I can't do my poem, but I want all his brothers to come up here and I want all his cousins to come up here and I want us to shout because Fat was a praiser. And I don't got a poem, but I got a shout down in my feet. So y'all, shout my mamosa, my mamosa. Woo, shout my mamosa, my mamosa, my mamosa.
His principal's coming. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Miss Smith. Yes, Lord. Miss Smith is coming. Yes, Lord. Is she here? Yes, Lord. Okay. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Come on, let's clap our hands for Miss Smith.
First, give an honor to God. It's a pleasure to be here. I am Miss Smith, and I had the, pleasure of knowing Geoffrey, and I'm so glad. I feel like I'm a part of the family. I did bring a couple of people, and Pastor, I'm going to honor your time, I promise you. But I do want you to know, and we all know, that it takes a community. We got a lot of stuff going on in our community. We just lost another student Monday night. So we got a lot of stuff going on in our community, but I do want to introduce you a couple of people that new fat at the school. Now, the first person I do want to introduce is our support, and she's our spokesperson at the district. This is Miss Patsy Scott. Glen Hills High School community is her community, so she's our spokesperson at the Board of Education. So this is Miss Patsy Scott. And to her left is Geoffrey's guidance counselor. She started with him last year. That's Miss Vaughn, and she was going to see him through graduation. And I want you all to know, I did tell Mom the other night when we had the vigil, Geoffrey will still graduate in the class of 2025. And Mom, either you, Dad, or family designee can walk across that stage and get his diploma. And we want all family, all of y'all in here, come to his graduation in 2025, because the Lord gonna keep us together and see him graduating in 2025. In a minute, you're gonna hear from one of his favorite teachers, Miss Walker. And right here next to me is Miss Moore. She is the new principal of Glen Hills Middle School, so again, it takes a village. I do wanna just take a minute to, I met Geoffrey. Now, we got over 800 students in our building. Every year, we're averaging 750 to 800 students. It's hard to know everybody, but your baby has a light. He has a light, and it's shown through the hallways of Glen Hills High School, so I got to meet him real early. I got to meet him last year because it was something about him. He came to us as, you know, coming out of eighth grade, as a ninth grader, first year in high school, my first year as the principal of Glen Hills Middle School, and he was a kid. He was a kid. He was a playful kid. He liked to play. He liked to play fight. He do those things. I say, Geoffrey, stop. He say, yes, ma'am, Miss Smith, and he go ahead and go to class. This school year, at the beginning of the school year, I saw something different in his face. He had matured. He went from that little playful ninth grader to, I'm a young man and I need to try to get myself straight to graduate. So when I saw him in the hallway at the beginning of this year, every day this school year, he always greeted me, good morning, Miss Smith. How you doing, Miss Smith? And I said, hey, Jeff, make sure you get out of the hallway. Yes, ma'am. You had a beautiful son, I told you, from the inside and out. I see where it comes from. You guys are a very spiritual family, and it was something in him. That's why I got to know him so early. It was something in him, and I am so glad to have been a part of his life. He will be a Glen Hills High School Spartan forever, and remember, in 2025, I'm coming to get you, because we're going to celebrate his graduation, okay?
Hi, everybody. I'm Miss Walker. So I wrote something so I wouldn't cry, but it's crying anyways. I'm his Algebra 2 teacher. I'm so honored to be chosen to speak for Geoffrey. First and foremost, I would just like to say I'm so sorry for your loss. And I'm not sure what the right words are to say, but Geoffrey was probably one of the sweetest, calmest, kindest souls I think I've ever came upon in teaching. First day of school, Geoffrey said, oh, hey, Miss Walker, came sat right next to me. I had a really big old class. So he came sat next to me. He said that was his seat, and he didn't care. So every day, he would just come and sit down. I was like, oh, Geoffrey's not here, but I see him clearly. He's next to me. But he'd be like, Miss Walker, and make this face at me. like, are you serious? And I'm like, yeah, like, where's Geoffrey at, guys? And I'm like, okay, just kidding. We talked a lot every day. Mostly it was talking about he wanted to join the band again to do the drums, and he wanted to play basketball. And he said because he was too fire. That's what he told me. Miss Walker, I'm too fire. Can't nobody beat me. Can't nobody outdo me. And I'm like, okay. And I'm like, so when you do it, I'm gonna come. And I said, just know I'm gonna embarrass you like I'm your parent. Cause I be, like all the kids, just yell, you know, their names, just embarrass them. Cause you're essentially mine at this point. And I didn't know Geoffrey very long, but like he's made a huge impact on me. And like my fifth period class, that's where it was. He was in my fifth period in. All the kids, immediately Sunday, I start getting like maybe like 50 messages. And you know, nobody's gonna contact me on the weekend. So I'm like, you know, what's wrong? And they're just asking me if I'm okay. And I'm like, why? So when they told me on Monday morning, they all ran into my homeroom and just hugged me and like, Miss Parker, are you okay? And I'm like, no, but I gotta be okay for y'all, you know? But I just wanna say, I love Geoffrey. Heaven has gained the sweetest angel. And if you guys need me, you can just message me. Thank you.
Is Barbie here?
I don't know, she's not an asker. Oh. She may be here.
Praise the Lord, church. I feel like the community that just spoke, this is a very difficult task. I'm not the best public speaker. That's why I always used to say, that's why I teach elementary school kids, because they real easy and they won't judge you when you mess up. I had Geoffrey at Meadowbrook Elementary School. I was his third grade teacher and his fourth grade teacher. I was honored to have him in third, and I said, whew, y'all get to leave and go to fourth grade. And here I am again. I had to loop with them. So I got him a second time. I spent 2 years with Geoffrey. And when I first met Geoffrey, I had to remember him as Geoffrey with the G, because we had two Geoffrey Johnsons, which was so strange. But one of them had a G, one of them had a J. So he was Geoffrey with the G in the beginning, because I had to figure out how was I going to remember these two Geoffreys. But with Geoffrey Johnson with a G, he was one of my babies. I knew him as a child, and he was always so happy. He would come in and he would smile, and he would be out his seat all the time. And I would say, Geoffrey, sit down. And he'd say, yes, ma'am. And he sat down. So he was always polite, always respectful, always mannerable. And I mean, he brightened up our classroom. You could tell when he was absent, because it was quiet. And I would always have to have him sit next to me so I could make sure he was doing his work. Not that he didn't want to, because he loved working. He loved helping me out. And when he was upset, you knew to leave him alone. And I would say, you okay today? No, ma'am. I say, you want to talk about it? Nope. Sometimes he'll say, yeah, such and such and such and such. But when he said nope, I said, okay. Go on and sit down. Put your head down. We'll start again tomorrow. And that's how our 2 years went. It's hard to, it's so many stories I could tell you. But you know, it's just hard for a teacher to talk for 1 to 2 minutes. So I just want to say that I loved him like my own baby. I have not seen him in years. I taught 21st century summer school and I had Charles. I don't know if Charles remember, but I taught him on teams. And Geoffrey popped his head in that teams. And I said, boy, how you been doing? And he just smiled. So you will always remember his smile. He always lit up the room. And boy, could he dress. Even as a child, he could dress. I mean, he came decked out. He had his boots on and his collar shirts in third grade, in fourth grade. I was like, this boy is something. And you never know what they're going to be when they leave you and what may happen to them. But I just want to tell the parents, I am honored. I know this is a difficult time, but I'm honored to be standing here because that means I did something for him. And he did something for me. He blessed our classroom every single day. And I sent out my condolences. I love him. I love you all. And if you ever, ever need me, please don't hesitate to call. Thank you.
These educators. Come on, let's thank God for these educators. They are truly unsung heroes. They spend so much time with the children more than they are at home. So we thank God for these educators that have made an impact on Fat's life. We're going to have the Johnson family come with a selection. Fat was blessed to be born into a gifted family on both sides. Very talented singers and musicians. Now, I don't know if I ever got to hear Shanae sing a solo, but I know his grandmothers, both grandmothers, and you heard his uncle. Amen. So he was born into a gifted family. So the Johnson's family is coming at this time to render us a selection.
Amen. Come on, let's clap our hands in here today. Amen. We are honored to be here on behalf of my nephew. We know him as Fat. I didn't call him Jeff because it was too many of them. It's one, two, and three. Of course, I didn't call my dad Jeff. And I did, my brother, I call him Jay. So just everybody had their names. But I do want to, on behalf of my family and I, just say thank you to everyone who's here in representation to the Richmond County School System, to Ms. Smith, Glen Hills High School, Ms. Moore, Glen Hills Middle School, amen, to Ms. Vaughn, guidance. I told Ms. Smith, I said, honey, you saw a whole bunch of them jokers, y'all ain't finished. And they keep coming and coming and coming. And to Ms. Patsy and to Ms. Walker and to Ms. Darby and to everyone here in representation. I was intentional with calling out the Richmond County School System, of whom I also represent proudly. Thank you. Amen. So I want to thank everyone, to everyone who's played a part. We're going to sing and we're going to get out your way. Is that okay? Amen. We're getting a little feedback. Amen. And I just want to tell y'all I love you. And I appreciate the representation here today and the impact that my nephew made on many of your lives. For he certainly made one on mine. I told him, as a matter of fact, when we was doing registration, when school started, and I was walking through the hall and I said, Fat, I said, don't play with me. You can be 6'3 all day long, but I will choke you. He's like, Auntie, come on, man. I said, and I will come up to this school and embarrass all y'all. Anybody was Flood or Johnson, play with me. He was like, Auntie, come on, man. So I'm glad to be here, and thank you all so much. And to Reverend Ramsey and to everyone, Apostle Parham, Bishop Watkins, Apostle Jones, thank you. We're going to sing we have not had any rehearsal because we definitely didn't plan for this, I can tell you that. But we're going to sing one of our known pieces, by the Hawkins, though. We didn't write this. Amen.
He failed.
Neighbor, be grateful. We're moving along. We're going to have reflections. Thank you, Johnson family. Beautifully orchestrated. God bless you. We're going to have reflections. All right, bro. My best moments with Fat from family and close friends, and the reading of the obituary by Miss Caldwell. And we'll have acknowledgments by Celebration of Life Funeral Home designee. In that order, amen? Tell your neighbor, I'm grateful for life. My best moments with Fat, who's designated for? It's reflections from family and close friends. Oh, amen, let's thank God.
Hello, everyone. I'm blessed to be Fat's eldest aunt, Latanya Brown, the eldest daughter of Shirley and Shirley Johnson, with Shirley. I've been thinking a lot about Fat and just the conversations he and I've had whenever when he would visit Boston, or the conversation we had when he was here. And I just remember what I keep seeing in my spirit and my heart is him crying about his grades dropping. And me talking to him about who he is and how he can work on his grades and do better. But what I saw in Fat is why I felt that I wanted to speak today, because this is for Fat, what I'm about to say, and it's for everyone here, and for my family, for my nephews, for my nieces. Fat's heart was so filled with love. He had so much love and so much tenderness for people and for his family. And he carried a lot on him and in his heart about family, about himself, about his brothers, about his sister. It was all there within him, his parents. It was always on his heart. And that's what I saw in his eyes when he was looking at me and crying. But he was still so protective that he wanted to protect his family, even while he was talking to me as his auntie. He didn't want to just go into what was wrong with him, but he just knew there was a weight on him. I want to say something about life really quickly in honor of Fat, and I'm not going to be that long, but some of the things that keep me are some of the things that we take for granted when we're young or teenagers. And I want to thank Big Jeff and my mother for doing something when I was young. And that is, we would have family Bible studies, and I would hear my mother praying, being in prayer. I'm saying this to you because the scripture says that when you train up a child in the way that they would go, when they grow older, they will not depart from what is deposited in them. And I'm saying this to everyone, that when life, there is nothing in the world like the peace of God. There is nothing in the world like the peace of God. We can go to substance. We can go to superficial things to fill a void. But only God can fill the void in what you seek. We're seeking for so many different things. And we're taking things that are superficial. It does not fill the void. You're thirsting, but you're thirsting for living water. You're thirsting and you're trying to fill a thirst with something that cannot be filled with alcohol, drugs, or lust. It will not be filled with those things. I'm a living witness of it. The reason why I'm saying this, because I'm also a church kid. And many of you are saying, well, I tried Jesus. I've shouted. I went in pursuit of him. And I'm still stuck with this. But Yeshua HaMashiach is speaking to everyone in here today. Fat's death is a redemptive death. Do you know why? Because his heart was pure before God. And he cried for his family. And he wept for his family. And I can speak as the eldest. And I'm telling everyone here to pursue Yeshua HaMashiach as if your life depended upon it. What you're in right now, it leads to nothing. It is void. The enemy wants to destroy us. The scripture says that the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. But Yeshua HaMashiach came to give us life. Life in this life and life everlasting. So don't pursue things that you know the outcome. I've already been there. I've done that. I've drank in this. I know where it ends. I've already been in this conversation. I know where it's going to lead. Until I set in my heart to pursue Yeshua HaMashiach, and I'm saying his Jewish name, and it is being deliberate because of what we do as church kids. Jesus is just, it just goes past us as if it's nothing. We say Jesus and we dance and shout, but when we go, we do the same thing. When the scripture says that when we are in Christ, we are a new creation, we are new. The old has passed away. There's a process of regeneration, but we become new. So I'm speaking this over the family as a family member. Pursue Yeshua HaMashiach. Pursue Yeshua HaMashiach. Commit your life to him. And I want to come against every spirit that says that you are cursed. You are not cursed. You are not cursed. You are not cursed. Geoffrey, you are not cursed. 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 He said, live. He said, live. Shanae, you are not cursed. You are not cursed. He said, live. He said, live. I come against the spirit of death, the spirit of suicide in the name of Jesus. We speak and prophesy life. Can these dry bones live? Can these bones live? Can these bones live? Yeshua HaMashiach, only you know. He said yes. He said yes, live. He said, yes, live. He said, yes, live. He said, yes, live. He said, yes, live. Whatever it is in your life that is keeping you from experiencing love like no other, the enemy wants to destroy families, wants to tear apart families and destroy relationships and friendships and whatever you have that's in agreement with someone that can make a difference on the earth, that can break chains, that can take people out of poverty, that can uplift. The enemy will fight it. But as a family and as a people, and I'm speaking to those of us of color, we allow things in our communities. And we're just taking the poison. We keep taking the poison and saying in the name of Jesus, I'm taking the poison. And our lives are ending. But I was blessed to observe people with wealth. They don't live the way we live. They're eating healthy. They change their eating habits. They're eating healthy. They have balance in their lives. They protect their family. They protect their friends. So when you're in a position where you feel like you want to scandalize or cut someone's throat, that is the enemy. So in honor of Fat, with the tenderness of his heart, Yeshua HaMashiach says, live. And I come against the enemy who says he is not real. Jesus is real. He is alive. It is not an aspiration. It is not a puffed up speech. It is not something of hope. I'm a living witness that he is alive. He changed my mind and my nature and my heart. I've seen people with wealth and they're seeking for what we know. I'm saying it because it's truth. Money doesn't give you access to peace. No, only Yeshua HaMashiach can. I'm not the preacher. But the Holy Spirit said life.
So I want to say, I don't know who's officiating, but when you all hear the opportunity to recommit your lives to Jesus, and if you don't know him today, I want to introduce to you Yeshua HaMashiach. He's a life giver. He'll give you a new name. He will bless you where you don't have anything, but then you have surplus. When you making your commitment of your heart that I'm going to pursue you, that I'm going to love you, he will bless you. I am a doctoral student. I shouldn't be. I'm a doctoral candidate at one of the leading evangelical seminaries in the country, at Gordon-Conwell Theological Seminary. I should not be there based on who I am or if you read my history. But that is Yeshua HaMashiach. It is not Tanya. It's because I said yes to him. I'm saying that to everyone because of the spirit that I feel in here. So if you feel that you want to recommit your life to Jesus, I want you to recommit. And my nephews and nieces, I want you all to stand up here right now, every single one of you. All of you, my nephews, my nieces, please come to the front. I know you guys are men. There's a purpose on you all's lives. And there is a seed put in you all's spirit before you were born. I'm saying to all of you, pursue Yeshua HaMashiach. He is real. He met me one evening and filled my heart with love and changed me, that I would do anything for him. I would go without food for him. I would be homeless for him. I would become whatever is needed to be like him in order for others. And what I see opposition in my life, I see it as an opportunity to win more people to him. We have up here doctors and lawyers and businessmen and wealth and musicians and people who are genius. The reason why I asked you all to come here, because one of the conversations I had with Fat was because after I spoke to Fat about his grades, I had a dream about Fat. I was lecturing at a college campus in the dream, and Fat was there. And I was talking, and in a dream he said, I went back to my seat, and he said, Auntie Tanya, is that what you see when you speak? And I said, yeah. He said, that's not what I see, Auntie Tanya. And when he pointed to the billboard, I looked, and it was all of these mathematical equations. And I looked, and I was like, I said, that's what you see when you look at this film? And he said, yes. So when he came to Boston, I told him the dream. And I said, Fat, I had this dream about you. Do you think this way? His face lit up. And he said, yes, Auntie, I think this way. His mind, he had a brilliant mind. And I'm not saying that as a loss. Many people say, but he died young. He did, but there's a purpose in all of it. That's why I said the Holy Spirit spoke and said it's a redemptive death. A redemptive death in bringing healing to our family. And healing even between my mother and my stepfather. And the reason why I'm saying this to you all is because the enemy desired to break families. And there's no offense to you, Crystal, I'm not offending people, okay? I'm speaking about what the enemy meant for evil. God is going to turn it around and use it for good. Shanae and Geoffrey, what the enemy meant for evil, the Lord is going to turn around and make good, use for his favor and goodness. It is not God when a family is destroyed. It is not him. It is us. It is our own stuff. I'm saying that because that is all around us, but it's broken by the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach on this day. Each of you will be married, and you all will have beautiful relationships. Yes, you will. You will pursue and love the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. You may not know it now. Auntie, I'm already done this church stuff because I said the same thing. All right. But I'm saying this out of love. If we ended this service without addressing these things because of Fat's heart, it wouldn't be true. But God bless. Thank you all. I love you all. I love you all. I love you all. I love you. Geoffrey, I love you. My apologies.
Amen. God has spoken. God is the most important person. What he says is more important than anybody and anything in this house. He has spoken to me. He has spoken through our sister. Amen. As pastor of this church, the servant of the Lord, who God has put in charge of what goes on in this church. At this time, according to what God has spoken to me, and what he has already said through our sister, what she said with what God has already told me. Amen. So at this time, we're going to extend the invitation to anyone who's ready now to make a decision to Christ. And then we're going to do the committal, and then we're going to dismiss, and then we're going to go eat. Amen.
Let's give God a great big hand clap. Let's bless the Lord. Oh, y'all can do better than that. Come on. Glory to God. I did not drive 3 hours. Amen for this. To Geoffrey, to the Johnson family, my prayers are with this family. And to the word that just was spoken. I was sitting right here. And I heard the Spirit of God when they got up the family to read the poems. I heard the Holy Ghost set the heart. He said the heart. He said the people got a heart condition. They shouting, but they got a heart condition. And when they heart need to be connected to me. Amen? Amen. So what we're going to do, we're going to call you up to come to Jesus. The Bible said, whosoever will, let them come. I don't care who you are, what you did, how you did it. God is calling you now. Today, if you want to be saved, you can be saved. If you're a backslider, come on. Amen. If you need to be healed, he's a healer. If you need to rededicate your life back to God, come on back. Come on. Amen. Will you please stand? Except the family. Will you please stand? Everybody else, please stand. Amen. I'm giving them the invitation. Yes. Not rushing. Amen. Do what the Holy Ghost say. Amen. You're looking at a person right here. Don't for to be in this pulpit today. 23% of my heart was pumping blood. April the 31st, they diagnosed with me congestive heart failure. You're looking at a miracle right now. When I had to go have a personal relationship with God, not church, I had to get out of religion. I had a personal relationship with God. I changed my eating habits. I came off of meats. I came off of sweets. I came off of sugar. I lost 58.8 pounds. 299 to 2, I came from 299.8 to 240 pounds. You're looking at a miracle right now. Now the doctors don't even know what's going on. I'm certain of God that is able to do exceedingly, abundantly above all we can ask or think. He's a healer. Just make your way to the altar. Just come on. Come just like you are. You can be wounded. You can be sad. Just make your way to the altar right now. God said, whosoever will, let them come. Amen. Come on, young people, come. Amen. This young man, amen, lit dark is not in vain. I come to tell y'all, glory to God, the spiritual number for 15, you know what it means? Rest. He's resting. He's resting. 15 means rest. He is not dead. He's asleep. He's sleeping in Jesus. But he's in heaven, come on somebody, and he's resting in God. Come on somebody, let's give God a great big hand clap. Come on, family, come back to Jesus. Come on, dedicate your life back to the Lord. Whosoever will, let them come. Amen, Jesus told the woman, amen, that was caught in the very act of adultery. Guess what he told her? He said, neither do I condemn you. He told her, he said, go and sin no more. I come to tell you, go and sin no more. I ask you to come. I ask you to come all over this place. Jesus is calling you right now. Jesus is calling you. Today might be your last day. Today may be your last day. Whosoever will, let them come. Young people, come. Give your life to Jesus. He's calling you. He's calling you. He's calling you. Amen. You can come just like you are. Come. 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 Come just like you. You're backslider. Even COVID-19 have done a lot to a lot of us. Some are sitting at home, won't even go to the house of worship. Come now. Come back. Rededicate your life back to God. Amen. Some of you are sick in your body right now. Come. Come just like you are. He's calling you just like you are. Whosoever will, let him come.
And I am.
I'm calling the backslider.
Oh, my story.
Yes. If there be no one else, this young man, we'll pray with you. We'll pray with you. Amen. Do you believe?
Oh!
in Jesus' name.
And Lord, look at him. I'm available.
Wait a minute. Would there be anyone else? Young man, thank God for you. Whosoever will, let him come. Welcome to the family of God. Lift your head up, son. Get in church. Not in the church. Okay? Don't associate to anybody. Get somewhere that you can be taught the word of God. Amen? Get in a good Bible-based church that can teach you the word of God. Amen? Do you understand that? Amen? God bless you. Heaven smile upon you. In Jesus' name. Let's give him a great big hand. Thank God for this soul. Amen. Let's give God a praise. Tell him thank you. Come on, y'all, stand to your feet and give God a praise. And tell him glory. 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 Yes. Tell him glory. Would there be anyone else? Before we close the door, in the name of Jesus, would there be anyone else? Amen.
As we make ready, let me say this. Life is about Jesus. One of the things that stood out about G3 was he was respectful and he honored authority. And the thought of God. Amen. I ask you, family, to receive, I don't know what her name is. This is
Latonya.
She's a apostle, right? You're the minister?
Yeah.
I thought so. Okay. God works in mysterious ways. I said, God works in mysterious ways. And God can do whatever he wants to do. We can't change what God chose to do today. This is the will of God for this beloved young man to be with him. Amen. We're going to just do our committal. And that's a tribute. And you think you're able to do it? Okay. Okay. Amen.
Do it, Jim. Do it, Jim.
Whatever you feel. As we do the Camilla, if the Lord speaks to you, then we will do the chorale song, and then we're going to go. Amen. God has spoken, and we want to remember him just as we remember him. Amen. Let us stand. for as much as death has once more invaded our ranks and removed from among us this outstanding, this loving, this praising, this true believer in Jesus Christ. I beloved Son in the Lord, his soul having to depart into undiscovered country, from whose born no travels return. His soul, which is with the Lord, the Bible says to be absent from the body, is to be present with the Lord. His soul that is delivered from the troubles of this life, the soul that has eternal peace, eternal happiness. He's gone while no travel returns. It has become our duty now to commit his soul, his spirit to the Lord, who is the supreme being over him, our maker, our father, and redeemer, and the confident hope of the coming again of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the resurrection of the body from the grave, and the joyous life for the children of light. Amen. We're going to listen now to this tribute, and then we will be dismissed. We invite you to join us in the fellowship hall, and there we will have, can we give God a hand of thanks for this wonderful life that God has spoken through? Amen. God has spoken through. Okay.
The family said they want to do their final viewing.
Trust me. my favorite verse. Yeah. I'll fight your battle. Anybody believe that? Let me hear you make some noise here. Hey, I'll fight your battle.
To do now. Let me have
He's been good. 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 He's been good.
Load of music. What we're gonna do now, as we make ready to leave the family, starting with the family, they're gonna do the final view, and amen. And then we will go out and we go to your right, and we come into the fellowship hall to eat. So with the morale, if you got a song that we can move with, preacher, would you follow after me? And then the family will view as we go out, starting with the family. Amen.
Master, the tempest is raging.
us all remain standing.
Storms are seen.
ask all the media family. We want the media family to please come this way. All of the media family, come this way. All the media family, will you come this way? It would be more convenient. And the rest of you, would you come after them? The media family, please come this way. Come to my left. All the media. We have a place for you to be seated. All of the media family, will you come to my left, the media family?